What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. And today, I was going to be doing like a $20 Walmart mod video for the truck. Like $20, whatever you find in like the car section, just something cheap. I thought it'd be a pretty cool video to do. But since the whole coronavirus thing, I'm probably not going to end up doing it, at least now. I will definitely do it when this is all passed. But for today, we're going to be doing a review, like a review slash reveal on the Avalanche. So, real quick, I gotta take the cardboard that's sitting in the back of it because it's been sitting back there for God knows how long. So, I'll get back to you guys once I get that cardboard out.
Oh yeah, I forgot the bike came. A whole ass bike. Wait a minute, I gotta take this to a recycling place.
I had to glue that tripod that I was using in the last video because it's like one of those like shitty Joby. G-O-B-Y, that's what the brand is. Gorilla tripods I've had since like 2015, which is made for like a phone. Not a full-size Canon, big-ass camera. So it should hold now, but not 100% sure on that one. All right, guys, so I'm gonna be taking the recyclables to the recycling place. But first, I'm hungry as shit. I'm gonna go get some McDonald's. I might record that too, I don't know. I might just take off the tripod and put it on the dash so it's not like super, it's like suspicious. Yeah, I'll just do that. All right, I'll meet you guys when I get to McDonald's. I'll have two sausage, egg, and cheese bagels, and...
I'm sorry, we don't have any bagels.
Oh. The two breakfast burritos, then.
God damn it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, damn! Come on, dude. It'll be all ass. Alright. Now that I'm doing breakfast, we can get on the rest of the video. Those are by far the shittiest burritos. Those were the shittiest burritos I have ever had from McDonald's. But nonetheless, we're gonna get on with today's video. We're going to the recycling plant. So I can empty out the cardboard in the back of the truck. That camera's bouncing around like a loop of cat ale. Alright, I'm just gonna get back to you guys when I get to the recycling plant, because it's starting to move that way too.
I'm just saying it right now, guys. I can guarantee you that the recycling plant is gonna be literally packed because of the whole coronavirus. This is its first day back open in like a month, I think, or around that time. So I guarantee you this place is gonna be packed. So I don't even know if I can film. Oh, damn. All right, we are approaching the recycling place right now. I think this guy in front of me is even turning in there. Holy shit. Oh my God, this place is packed. Yeah, guys, I won't be able to film this, sadly. But I'll get back to you. Alright, guys, so, like, as I was saying, there was literally no room for me to, like, almost there was, like, no room for me to park. So, I didn't even get the camera out. I didn't even think it was, like, you know, worth it. I will record me getting back because now all that crap is out of the bed. And we can do the review today. Well, guys, I didn't get to wash the truck off like in that video because I figured out later on that it was gonna be raining. So I just didn't even, it's pointless to wash your truck off and then it rained like a few hours later. Right now, I am in my motorhome right now. Videos on this will probably be coming soon too. This thing's kinda dope. But for right now, I'm just focused on what we're gonna do with the Avalanche. And it's windy as shit outside. I don't know if you can hear it. I can hear it. Yeah, the roof's fucking rattling for how goddamn loud it is. Reveal video will be coming soon. But for right now, no. Not right now. Here's the thing though, the Avalanche, I know, it's not like this super special truck. Like the Monte Carlo is more special obviously because it's more rare. It's a sports car, all that. The Avalanche, it's just a Z71 Avalanche with a 5.3 in it that is well taken care of apart from the transmission and some rust. I still think it deserves to be a video made on it because one, it's a pretty cool truck. Apart from that, I know this video kind of sucked ass guys, but like, I don't really know what else I could do for the video per se. I can give you guys a quick tour of the motorhome. There will be some videos. This thing's pretty dope, all right? So me and my, I can feel this. I can literally see this thing rocking because of the wind. Holy shit, it is windy as hell. Like, look outside. Look at the angle it's at right now. Yeah, it's not doing it justice. It's windy as hell today. I'll give you guys a quick glimpse on the motorhome. All right, so right here, you'd walk in. Let me get rid of this real quick. Listen to that. Oh yeah, by this thing, by the way, this thing ain't perfect. This is a 1982 motorhome. Chevy Jamboree. Like, this is the right ceiling right here. This is the right material right here. As you can see, should sound like that. That don't sound like that. This moves. Not good. So what we did is we legit just bought a tarp and stapled it over the wood. You can see the wood right there. But overall, okay. We bought this thing for $800. And by the end of the day to get it running and everything, we probably spent around like, I'm gonna say like $1,200, $1,300. So that is a good ass deal. You got a big ass motorhome for $1,200. What the hell are you complaining about? And like, to be totally honest, it's not complete like awful condition. Like the floor, yeah, it's a bit dated, a bit stained, but like, look at this shit. It's not like all torn up and shit. You may be wondering what these wires are for right here and why they go down here. They actually hide under this little panel right here into the battery. Because this bitch has an amp. You guys can see it, an amp in here. And we installed secondary speakers like that one right in there. You guys can see it right here. And you've been wondering what the hell is this fucking extension cord doing on this shit? Like, why is there an extension cord on here? Well, if you follow this down, you will notice that there is a subwoofer in a 1982 motorhome. And not just one subwoofer. If you look under the table, I have to clean this up a bit. There's two subwoofers. There's two subwoofers. And look at the rear speakers. They're, what is it, Alpine? There are two Alpine speakers back here. A speaker here in this little, this is where the microwave used to be. One up there, like I said, and two up here by the driver and the passenger. Like, this, we were just doing like a budget, like, just the absolute, like, dank mobile, and we achieved it by far. Well, we got some old ass soda in here. But yeah, like I said, like, up here, there's legit a bed up here, and a, like, a nice soft mattress. There's a blanket, pillows, like, it's a good mattress too. Like, look at this thing. It's not dirty and shit. Now the bathroom we are using as like a storage facility right now, so don't judge it. But again, not bad. Again, and there's a shower in here too. So I mean, damn, we ain't using the shower, but you know, it's good to have one. An AC unit, fucker, looks like mint, almost brand new. Got a heater in it, which pumps heat out. That little grate right now, that's the intake. It pumps the heat out these little, those little fins down there and right down there. I just gotta say thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you guys so much for tuning into my videos. Actually taking the time out of your day to watch them. I will see you in the next one.